He smiled at me. As he talked, his eyes widened tremendously and his smile grew broad. His hands were very soft and white as his face, and his brown beard, though neatly trimmed, was ragged, as though it were moth-eaten. "I often kill," he said to me. "This is the first time you have known it. I love my wife very much, so much I wanted to kill her. You know the legend of the loup-garou, the werewolf? There were some sheep in a meadow outside Tours not long ago, Herr Doctor. I killed one of them, and then I fancied it would be nice to kill the wife of the farmer who lived there. I have a way of getting into houses, Herr Doctor, which nobody knows but myself. That night I tapped on the window pane and beckoned to this woman, but she refused to come out. I think she was frightened by the blood on my mouth. But I was tired, and so I let her alone." Often he would twitch his shoulders as with some nervous melody, and once he touched my arm. Usually he sat quiet with that silky brown beard and the smile and the wide eyes behind his spectacles. Ah, yes, another thing I remember made an impression on me. He said, "They're going to shut me up, friend. They'd better not, because they can't keep me there. You know that lovely line, 'Oh, whistle and I'll come to you, lad.' Tell them to remember that, won't you?" The big Austrian, whose precision of detail had created a ghastly picture, completed his notes and sat back. "He said that, did he?" asked Benkelin after a pause. "Well, Doctor, I will take up the story because I think you will be interested.